What's up guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use WordPress to create a landing page. The method I'm going to show you is very simple and straight to the point. And without wasting any time, let's just jump straight into the tutorial. This is the sample of the page we are going to create. And it's just a simple landing page where I'm giving a free ebook as a lead magnet. I have the title of the book boldly written at the top, a 3D image of the book cover, a short description of the book, and then an opt-in form where people can get to enter their name and email address to become my lead and then go ahead to download this ebook for free. To create a landing page like this, open your WordPress dashboard. The first thing we are going to do is to install a plugin called Elementor. So come over to plugins, then click on add new. Come over here and search for Elementor. Here is a plugin we are going to use, Elementor Website Builder by elementor.com. And as you can see, it has over 5 million active installations. So just go ahead and install this plugin. After installing, just activate. Elementor is now active on our website. You don't have to worry because we can actually use the free version of Elementor for this process. Now that we have Elementor ready, let's go over and set up the page. So come over to pages, click on add new. I'm going to give my page a name. So I'll just name it free ebook, right? Since I'll be giving out a free ebook from this landing page, then just go ahead and publish. After publishing, if I preview this page in a new tab, this is what we have at the moment. Now I'll come back here and then go ahead and click edit with Elementor. That will open the Elementor editor for us. And this is where you can get to customize your page. You can click on this folder icon. Here you can pick from templates that you can use, but I want to create a very simple page. So I'm going to start designing from scratch. So the first thing I'm going to do is to add a section. And if I click on this plus icon, I can get to choose the structure I want to use for this section. I'm going to use the first one here. If you want to have double columns, you can select these three columns and all of that. And then by the left here, you are going to see all these widgets available for you. I'm going to drag in a heading so that I can type in the heading of my lead magnet. So I'm going to use 21 effective ways to build your website traffic fast. This is the name of the lead magnet I'm giving out from this page. And this is what I'm going to use as my title. Now you can get to customize this text that you have here. Let's say if I want it to be super big, I'm going to change the tag from H2 to H1. And then you can also select from different sizes here. Maybe if you want large or extra large and all of that, that's completely up to you. You can use anyone you want. Then the alignment, I'm going to align to the center. Then if you want, you can add a link to this text. And if you come over to style, you can select the text color. I'm going to use something in the blue region. Also, you can edit the typography, the font type, the font size. Elementor has all the tools you can use to fully customize everything on your page. You can edit stuff like the line height, also the letter spacing, the word spacing, the style, and all of that. For the weight, I'm going to use extra bold. You can add text stroke, shadow, and all of that. Let's say I'm cool with the way this is. The next thing I'm going to do is to bring in a new section. So I'll just bring in a one column section again, then come over to widget. Then I'm going to drag in the image widget so that I can add an image to this section. Hover your mouse to this point and click on choose image. Then I'll just upload the image I want to use. I'm going to select this, then click on select. Now this is the image here, but this is quite too big. So I'm going to try to reduce the size. I'm going to select large and probably this better. Let's say if you want to use a custom size for your image, you can just under image size, select custom, and then you can enter the size you want to use, both the width and the height. Let's say I want to use 300 by 300 pixels. I'll click on apply and this is it, but this is too small. So I'll just go with the large option. Then the alignment, I'll align to the center. You can add a caption if you want. Then you can add a link. Then if you come back to style, you can adjust the width, the height, all of this kind of stuff. You can play with it right here. But let's say I'm good with the way it is right now. The next thing I'm going to do is to bring in another section. And what I want to do right now is to add a text, just like a description of this PDF. So I'll come back to widget and then bring in text editor, drag it in. And then just paste the text I want to use. And this is basically it. You can actually edit your text as well. Maybe if you want to make some part of the text bold. And if you come over to style, you can play around with the alignment. I'm going to align from the left. Then for the color, I'm going to use complete black. Then also you have a lot of options with the typography. You can actually adjust the size, then the weight of the text. But let's say I'm cool with this. I'm just going to add a call to action. So this is my call to action. Enter your name and email in the form below and click download now to download this ebook for free. I'm going to just kind of make this bold. Now, the next step for us is to bring in the form that people can actually fill in order to be able to download the ebook. And to create my form, I'm going to use system.io. If you don't have a system account yet, I'm going to leave a link in the description that you can use to sign up. You can easily create a free account with system.io and use that to design the form that you can use on your landing page. There are a lot of form builders on WordPress, but they don't actually have the features that system.io is going to offer you. Aside from creating your form with system, you can also manage everything about your email marketing from system.io. And you can start with this completely for free. For instance, if I come over to Elementor and here under widget, if I search for form, you are going to see that there's a form feature, but this is only available to premium users, right? That means you have to pay in order to be able to use this form feature directly from Elementor. And this is the case with most of the form builders you are going to find on WordPress. They'll either ask you to pay before you can use them, or those ones that are available for free, they just don't have the features that you are going to use to enjoy your email marketing process. But with system, you can start using it for free, and then you can collect emails, send out newsletters, set up automations, and all of those kind of stuff. So after creating your account, just sign into your system.io account. I'm going to sign into my account right now. In your system dashboard, come over to funnels and then click on create to create a new funnel. I'm going to give my funnel a name, let's say free ebook. Then I'm going to select the domain I want to use. By default, you are going to have this domain with your system username, .system.io, but you can link a custom domain to your system account. Either ways, this is not going to be a big deal because we're actually embedding this form on our WordPress page. So I'm going to select this domain, then choose your funnel goal. I'll use build an audience, then select the currency you want to use. I'll just select Naira at this point, then click on save. My funnel has been created. I just need to click on it. By default, system is going to give you squeeze page templates, but because I'm not creating a squeeze page, I'm going to delete this. Then what I'm going to do is to click on add step, then just give this step a name. I also use free ebook. Then the step type, for the type you want to select inline form, this type of form we want to create. So choose inline form and then click on save. And then I'm just going to drag this above the thank you page. You can pick any of these templates. So let's say I'm going to select this. Then I'm going to click on this edit page icon. The only thing I'm going to need from here is the form itself. So I'm going to delete all of these. Delete this as well. Right now we have a space for email address. I can just duplicate this and then use the one on top as a space for name. So just click on settings. And then input type, you want to change it to first name. That's what I'm going to use there, right? So then I can also select the button and then click on this settings icon. If I scroll down, the button text, I'll change it from click here to download now. Then you can adjust the font size, the line height. I'll just use all of that the way it is. Then you can also customize what happens when people click on this button. So I'm going to use send form so that I'll be able to collect the name and email they'll enter on the form here. If you select any other function, you are not going to see the details they'll submit here in your system account. So select send form. Then you want to select where people are going to be redirected to after they click on this button. So I'm going to click on to the next step. Then I'll click on save changes. Our form is ready, but I want the color of my form background to match the color of my page. I'm going to use this blue color. So I'll just copy the code, come over to system, then click on settings. For background color, I'm going to just enter my code. Then I'll click on save changes and then just click on continue. The next thing I'm going to do here is to customize the thank you page. So click on thank you page, and then you can just select any of these templates. Let me see. I'll just look for one that is very simple. I'm going to use this. I'll click on select. Then I'm going to click on this edit page icon. I'll delete all the stuff I don't need on this page. Delete this. Then delete this as well. So we have thank you for signing up. Click the button below to download the ebook. So I'm going to use that. Then I'm going to add image of the book here. Just upload the image. Just reduce the size of the image a bit. Then I'm going to click on start your download button. For the action when button is clicked, I'm going to select download file because I want them to be able to download this ebook. And then I'm going to upload the ebook itself. So this ebook, just upload it. Now, when people click on this start your download, the ebook is going to be downloaded to their device. Once I'm done with all of this, I'm going to click on save changes and then click on continue. Now our form and our thank you page is ready. With all of these in place, let's go ahead and insert the form on our page. So I'll click on the form, which is this free ebook here, and then click on script. This is the HTML script for our form. Just click on copy script to clipboard and then come over to Elementor where we were customizing our page. I'm going to add a new section and then under widgets, search for HTML, just drag in the HTML widget and then paste my script here. Remember the script you copied from your system form. And once you have that in place, I'm going to click on update. Now I'll come over, let's refresh our page and let's see what it looks like right now. Just refresh. And this is what our page looks like at the moment. So people can come over to this page, just see all of these details and then enter their name, their email address, and then go ahead and download. So let me just show you a quick example. I'm going to enter my name and email address, and then I'm going to click on download now. It brings us over to our thank you page. I can just go ahead and click on start your download, and this book is going to be downloaded. So this is how this simple funnel works. Also, you can double check how your page is going to look like on different device sizes. So to do that, just click on this responsive mode and then you can select mobile. Yeah, this is what it's going to look like on mobile. Let's say this heading probably looks too big. I'll just select it. And then under typography, I can just reduce the size. Then I also reduce the line height so that I'll have something like this. So you can just follow through and make sure your page looks good on different device sizes. And once you are done, just go ahead and click on update. At the end of the day, this is what our landing page looks like. And that's basically it, guys. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. And before you go, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one.